Hi everyone, thank you very much for joining my channel today. Today I want to give all the glory to God for a specific thing. This thing is my hair. As you can see, I have really beautiful hair, natural black hair. I want to show you the life, and then I'm going to give you my testimony about that. So, as you can see, my hair is this long on the right side, and the length on the left side is here. The left side is here. And I'm going to show you on the back. Okay, so you have seen my hair. Why do I want to do that and to show that? It's because, thanks to God, today, I can say that I love myself. I can say that I believe I'm a really beautiful, woman. I have a beautiful face. I have a beautiful skin. I have beautiful hair, and I say that because it's not thanks to me that I am beautiful. It is thanks to God, because God created me and He made me really beautiful, and I am a beautiful woman naturally. I have a natural beauty that God gave me, and I want to thank Him for that. And I want to thank Him for my hair, because He has answered my prayer. So today I can say that, but for many years, I couldn't say that. For many years, I felt I wasn't feeling good about myself. I didn't love myself. I didn't think I was beautiful. I had self-esteem issues, and it took me really many years before I could say that I love myself. So I can say that officially since 2012, I began to really love myself and to really accept myself as a beautiful woman of God. But the years before that, I was struggling against self issues, and I remember that I had prayed God about that, because when I gave my life to Jesus, I was a teenager, I was 14 years old, and for me it was easy to love God, because God is perfect. He has never sinned. He has never done anything wrong, and I know that God wanted me to love other people also, but somehow I couldn't accept the fact that God wanted me to love myself also, because I thought that I was a sinner, that my sin was so ugly, and for me it was I couldn't understand that it was my duty and it was a pleasure for me to love God, and I wanted to love other people because God wanted me to do that. But I couldn't accept the fact that God wanted me to love myself. I knew that intellectually that God wanted me to love myself, but it was a struggle for me. I didn't think a lot about it. It was subconscious. And then when I went to high school, once I reached my 16th birthday, a classmate, she was a girl, and she was a believer also, but not really a strong believer, but she believed also. And she told me that, "No, Geraldine, God told you to love other people, God told you to worship Him, but He also told you to love yourself, so that is important that you can learn to love yourself." And when she told me that, I was so shocked because I knew she was right. For me, it was a revelation, and I knew she it was the truth. But still, it was difficult for me. So I asked God to help me. I prayed God to help me to love myself because I knew it was His will. So He answered my prayer, but not right away. It was quite a long way before I could see the result of that. Because when somebody was telling me that I was beautiful, or I was attractive, really, I couldn't believe that. I thought that this person was telling me that in order to be nice, but I could not accept that it was the truth. So the thing that helped me was the word of God. When I saw in the Bible that I was the apple of the eyes of God, I thought, "Wow, my God, my goodness, that is very precious, that is very special." And there are plenty of Bible verses that talk about the fact that as children of God, we are precious, that we are beautiful. There are plenty of verses in which God declares His love for us, and those verses explain, for example, the verse that tells that I am a wonderful creature. Another verse says that my body is a temple of the Holy Spirit, and also that God will love me with everlasting love, and that I am chosen, that I am precious in His eyes, that He has counted all the hairs upon my head. Plenty of verses like that show me that God truly loved me, that God truly cherished me, and that I was really beautiful in His eyes, and that I was so precious that Jesus died for me, and He raised again to give me eternal life, eternal salvation. So once I understood that, I was free, and I began to see myself with the eyes of God. I began to accept myself and to love myself because God loves me. I love me because God loves me, and that's because of that I was freed. Then, regarding my hair and my skin, I didn't feel comfortable in my own skin. I did not know how to take care of my skin, how to take care of my hair. So I prayed God to show me the way. I asked God to help me to take care of my skin and my hair. And I began to make searches on the internet. And thanks to God, I found plenty of informations that give advices and tips with natural products such as olive oil, coconut oil, and aloe vera, water, plenty of it that helps to protect your skin, nourish your skin, and also your hair. And also I found plenty of tips in order to eat well, in order to drink plenty of water, plenty of things like that. So God really guided my path, and today I love myself. I thank God for my beautiful body. I thank God for my beautiful skin and for my beautiful face, for my beautiful hair. And I am a wonderful creature of God. And I want to say to you also, to you who struggles with self-esteem issues, that it's not the end of the world. God wants to help you. God wants to give you freedom in that area, and really you can ask him and he will answer you as he did for me, because God doesn't God is not a God of favoritism. And regarding my hair, they have grown, because for years they were stagnant on my shoulders. I was wondering how to take care of my natural hair, because they were natural, but I did not know how to make them grow. And again, God answered my prayer about that, and he gave me tips to take care of them. So the tips are quite simple. It's important to have a good nutrition, because the air receives all the nutrients that comes from your body. So it's important to have plenty of vitamins, to drink plenty of water, eat plenty of fruits, of vegetables, stay away from things that are really that contains too much sugar or too much salt or too much toxic products. That's it. And also to protect the ends of your hair, because the more your hair grows, the more you have to take care of the ends, because even if your hair grows, if your the ends are not taken are not undone properly, they can be damaged. So to take care of your ends, you have to make protective styles, and there are stylish protective styles. There are also examples on YouTube, and you can also on night put either you can use a satin scarf, or you can use a pillow case with a satin upon it. And I don't use comb and I don't use brush, because the natural black hair are not straight hair. So if you use brush or comb, it will damage your hair. So I use my finger. So those are the tips I use. I also take aloe vera sometimes, spirulina and vitamins. So those are my tips. I hope really it helps someone, and I pray that God gives you victory in this area if this is difficult for you. So may God bless you, and may God bless you. Bye.